I'd like to show you how to construct the LR1 automaton for this grammar. And as always, S is our start symbol, but we have to add a new rule where S bar expands to S. So our tree will more look like this. That's because we may have the S on the right hand side of the rule, the start symbol. But we don't want to find a full S for a right-hand side, but we want to find a symbol that spans the whole input word. That's why we always add a new rule for that. So we begin with pre-compiling the states. In the first state, we use our rule S bar expands to S, and we didn't see anything yet of that S. That's why we write the dot on left of the S, and we use a look ahead of 1. That means we want to see what we want to keep in mind what's behind those S. And as you can see, when S spans the whole word, or in this case, there's nothing behind it. Well, at least there's the end of the word behind it, and that's why we write a dollar symbol for that. So that means that there's the end of the word behind that. Well, I can do this more beautiful later. So now we want to predict the S. And we have two rules for that. We have S expands to BC, where we didn't see anything yet of BC. And behind those S, there's the dollar sign, as you can see here. And we can use the other rule for prediction. So S expands to DA. And again, with nothing but the end of the word behind that. Now we can do even more predictions. We can do the prediction for that B. And we have one rule for that. So B can expand to a terminal B, which we didn't see yet. But we don't. Now we have in the look ahead not the dollar sign. Because as you can see here, when B is on the left hand side of. On the right hand side of this rule, but left on the right hand side, then. Right from this B, there's a C, or as you could see at this rule, and C. Well, you have to look what C can. What's the first symbol is that C can become. So, as you can see, C expands to double A, and A expands to a terminal A. So the next symbol that's after the next terminal symbol that's behind the B is a terminal A. That's why we write an A here. And now we can't do any prediction more for that, but we can do a prediction for that. So we use D expands to BA. And let's have a look at those picture, and you can see that D will be followed by an A, and in this grammar there's nothing else possible, otherwise I would have to consider all possibilities. So now I can draw a nice frame, because there's nothing to add for this state anymore. Now, what can we do? As you can see here, we have two terminal symbols that we may encounter next. So I draw a new state where we saw the terminal B next. And now we have two possibilities for this rule. If we had used that rule, we can move the dot over that. Because when we read a B, then we saw it, so we are allowed to move the dot to that position. The look ahead will be the same, it's still an A. And well, we could also have the possibility that we use that rule, and then we are allowed to move the dot over that B. So we get this rule in those state as well, and we keep the aim. There's nothing more to add and nothing to predict anymore, so I draw the frame for that. As next I could go that possibility. Well, as you may could see, if we read an A next, then we may have used that rule and we have to go back and use the full B we saw already, or we could have that possibility where we just had used that rule and we just want to see those A next. So the next state we get from here is we where we you where we move the dot over that A. And there's nothing more to add to this state because we handle the sorry, because we handle the B in another state. So, but nevertheless, now we are here, we can go back to this place again because either we had a B from a full B from here, then we can move the dot over the B, or we got a full or we saw a full D here and then we can move the dot over the D. So, let's take the D next. It doesn't really matter. So if we may use that rule, D expands to BA, and then we read a B, and then we read an A, then we saw the full right-hand side of the rule, D expands to BA. That means we got a full D when we read B and A before. So we have to go back to this state where we started reading the where we started processing the right-hand side of the rule, and now we can move the dot over rules that have a D on the right-hand side behind the dot, and that would be this rule. So if we got the whole D, we can move the dot over that D. And now we can, well, that's the only rule that had a D be a capital D behind the dot. And now we can use predictions again, so we have to predict for the A. Oh, I forgot something. Sorry, I have to add the look ahead as well, and that's a dollar sign. Because it's a dollar sign here as well, and I just keep it. So now I do the prediction for the A. I have got only one rule to use for the A, so it's A expands to A. And now let's see what's in the look ahead of A, and as you can see, A is the last non-terminal on the right-hand side from the rule from the start symbol. And so as you can see here, maybe behind those A, which corresponds to the A in that rule, behind those A, there's just the end of the word. So we have in the look ahead, we have just the word end. Now we are done with that. And now we have, the next possibility from here is that we read an A. So I draw another state where we read this A and we are allowed to move the dot over this terminal A. And we just keep the look ahead. And there's nothing left to add. Because that was the only rule that had the terminal A, behind the dot. Now, when we went to this state and we read the whole right hand side of that rule, then we got the and we got then we saw the full right hand side of those A. That means we got an A. And now we are allowed to move the dot over that A. That means here we get another state where we have the dot on the right hand side of this rule. Or on the, sorry, on the, at the end of the right hand side of the rule. Well, that's the only rule, the only item that we need in the state here. And now if we are here then and we have the dot on the right hand side of the S rule, that means we saw the whole S, and we are allowed to go back to where we started reading the right hand side, that's here. And now if we saw the whole S, then we are allowed to move the dot over that S. And this will be our final state, where we saw everything of the input string. And because that is our final state, we just draw two borders around it, two frames. And here I nearly forgot the arrow. But we are not done yet, because I didn't consider the possibility where we had a whole B here. And when we got the when we were here and we read the terminal B, and we used that rule, and now we have seen the whole right hand side of the B rule, then we got the non-terminal B here, and we are allowed to move the dot over the B. And that's what I have to consider yet. So when we move the dot over that B, we get a state where we moved the dot over the B, and now it's between B and C. And we just keep the look ahead. Now, because the next symbol behind the dot is a non-terminal, I have to do prediction for that, and I have to predict C expands to A. With dot, of course. And if you can, as you can see here, or maybe as you can see in the picture, then you see that behind the C we have nothing left. So behind the C, in the look ahead, our look ahead is the word end sign. Now we can do another prediction for A. We have just one rule to predict from, so A may expand to a terminal A. And that is, this A is the first A on the right hand side of the rule. And as you can see on the graph here, you see that behind that A you can only have an A. So in the look ahead you have an A. But now we are done with that state. Now we can, as next, we can read the A as input symbol, so I have to add another state where I move the dot over that A, and we keep the look ahead. That's everything I can add to that state. And if we did that, then we read the whole, then we saw the whole right hand side rule of the A rule, and that means we can go back to here. And we saw the whole A, that means we are allowed to move the dot over that A. So we got, when we got the whole A, we are allowed to go to this state where we saw the first A. And we just keep the dollar symbol from here. Now I can do another prediction. And as you can see here, or as you can see here behind ZA, you don't have anything. So you have a look at the, in the look ahead, you have the dollar symbol. And in this case, we can read the other terminal A. And we get a new state. Well, at least this state will be the same as that state, so well, you could join the two, but I well, in my picture I can't draw an arrow through all the things. It would mess the whole picture up, so I added it as another state, but you you could do it more efficiently when drawing. If you have the same, instead of drawing the same state several times, you could just draw an arrow to the state, if that's the case. So this state is basically the same as this state. So because when we reach those state, we always have to go back from where we came from. So it doesn't really, if there are two arrows, then you would just go back the arrow where we came from before. So it's, well, it's the same state, and I just had to draw them twice in this case. So now, in the, when I read the whole A, then I can, then I'm allowed to move the A over that rule, or over that, and I am allowed to move the dot over that A. When I read the second one, now I, when in this case I read the whole, I read everything I needed to get the whole scene, so I can go back to where I started reading for this rule, and that's here. And here I have to add another transition where I read the whole scene, and I'm allowed to move the dot over that symbol. And now if I'm here and I write the rule S, then I could move back to this state and, well, use that transition. And I guess I considered now all possibilities, and I'm done recreating my LR1 automaton.